Hey, welcome back to my channel. If you haven't seen any of my other videos, because this is my second video, welcome. Hey, so today I am drawing a damselfly or dragonfly, however you call it. I don't really know the difference between them. I'm just gonna say it's a dragonfly. I did speed this video up a little bit because the other one was so long. I didn't want it to, you know, just take up like an hour of your life or whatever. So I did try to speed it up a little bit. So I'm just gonna let you guys be now, and if there's anything important that I need to say that's happening in the video, I will say it. So there is a little too much water in that one part of the lily pad, and I do fix that up in a few seconds, I guess, in the video. Now I'm just adding some shading around the dragonfly. I think it adds a little bit of contrast. It mainly just shows that, you know, the dragonfly is actually doing something, that it's not just a dragonfly in a lily pad, that maybe the dragonfly is sitting on the lily pad or flying over it even. Also, there's a little piece of the lily pad, I don't know if you can see it or not, that is not colored in. I just realized that, so I took a marker and I just filled that in. So just wanted to let you guys know that.
to Italy. I fall in love to Italy.
So, now I'm coloring in the flower part of the lily pad. Excuse me. I wasn't going to have it there, but then I realized, well, if I don't have this flower, it's just going to be a bunch of green and blues, and no one really likes that. And plus, it doesn't really stand anything out except for the body. So, with the flower underneath it, it really sort of pops, you know, itself and the dragonfly. And I did just realize that there isn't any shading underneath the dragonfly on the flower part, so that's what I'm going to do, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to have a photo at the end with the updated version. I'm just going to have a before and after. Editing me, remember that. Start coloring in the dragonfly. I start with the body. I have two different colors that I do it with, as you can see, well, as you will see. I think I like it with the two different colors. I feel like if I just had one color, then it would just sort of be boring. Sorry, the guinea pig's eating its food. It likes to knock the tray over, and I have to fix it back up again, but you know, it's okay. As I was saying, though, if there weren't two colors, like a darker and lighter color on the body, I don't think it would really stand out as much. I mean, you'll see it in a little bit, like right after this part, I get the other color out and I start putting that in. Actually, the head and the thing below the head, where the first two wings are connected to, those are actually the same color. That's like one thing that I really like about watercolors, that you can get different colors, but just with one pen, and that's something I really enjoy about it, and that's actually a tip for anyone who's looking forward to getting watercolors. I think my next video will actually be watercolor tips, or just showing you how to do watercolor, so look forward to that.
fall in love too easily. I fall in love too easily. I fall in love too easily.
So now, like I usually do when I'm done actually painting or drawing whatever I draw, I usually go over with my jelly roll and my black Micron pen, or just a black pen even. It's really usually anything. With the Micron, I add in the eyes and I sort of sketch over some things that you can't really see well, or I think just need to stand out a little more, or just small details that I decided to add. Sorry. The guinea pig's drinking water. So I am going to, excuse me, I'm going to have a montage like usual, and you will see that in a little bit.
Thank you.